Let's take a look at the onDeleteSetNull constraint next. So once again, I'm going to go back over here. I'm going to drop my table of photos. So it looks like the drop is complete. And then I'm going to recreate that table. So I see create table photos right here. And then once again, after our foreign key column definition, I will put in onDeleteSetNull, like so. Now before we try to run this, remember, we have a insert statement right here that's trying to insert three photos that are all related to the user with ID number one. If we were to run this right now, we would end up getting an error message. And the reason for that is that there is no user with an ID of number one anymore. We deleted that user just a moment ago in the last video. That user does not exist. So if we were to run this insertion statement, we would end up with an error saying, hey, sorry, but there's no user to relate these photos to. So just for this particular test, I'm going to delete those three lines right there. So for this test, we'll instead try to delete photos tied to our user with ID 4 and just make sure that the related references get set to null instead. Okay, so I'm going to run this. It looks like the create was successful. And so now we can kind of picture what's going on inside of our database. It'd be something like this. This is what we currently have. Now we're going to try to delete the user with ID 4. Because we are using that set null on delete constraint, once we delete that user, all the related photos will have this value inside the user ID column set to null, like so. Let's try this out. I'm going to delete all the SQL we just wrote and replace it with delete from users where ID equals 4. I'm going to run that, and it looks like it was successful. So now we can once again take a look at all of our different photos. So select star from photos, run that, and we can see very easily that we now have two photos inside of here with a user ID of null. So where would we want to use this? Well, this might be very useful if a user were to create some kind of resource, and then if we decided to, for some reason, delete that user, and then eventually said, okay, well, we still want to show the underlying photo. Maybe, for example, in the Instagram application, we might need to delete some kind of problematic user or ban them or something like that. But the post that they created might be very meaningful, and so maybe we want to hold those posts around. So that might be a scenario where we want to hold the related records around, even if we delete some other record that these things depend upon. Okay, so that is the set null constraint. Now we're going to take a look at setting up a default value and using the set default constraint in the next video as well.